are staying on top of the storms and flooding this morning. One of the hardest hit areas, you just heard from Jason, is Oskaloosa. And some residents have been trapped by the flooding there. Right now we have Joe Millage on the phone again with us. He's a reporter with KIIC out of Albia. Okay, Joe, do we know, have all these residents been rescued yet?
Katie, it does look like they've all been rescued as of about 5:20 or so. When we got here just a little bit after 5 o'clock, they were trying to launch boats from New Sharon and Eddyville, trying to fight the currents and get to these folks that were stranded. I'm here now with Victor Hampton, who owns the property where about 10 people were stranded, three different tenants, and about 10 people. And, Victor, you said that you got a call actually this morning earlier. What did they tell you?
They just told me we needed help. They're standing on top of a van, knee deep in water, and out in the driveway. And then when I got up out of bed and come down this way, I drove through the water on the road. But when about a mile up the road, I come back, and I couldn't even get through it. It was just plumb over the road.
And Victor says he's never seen anything quite like this, Katie. And the folks that were, he's lived here 30 years, and the folks that were on the van actually had water up to their knees. And the father was holding one of his kids. He had ages 4, 6, and 8 on top of the van with him. But kudos to the local rescuers who got to these folks in time. And the folks from Oskaloosa, New Sharon, Eddyville, and all those that responded potentially may have saved 10 lives here this morning. And the water's receding. The pictures that you may have seen is debris in the road in the middle of Highway 92. They've just brought in some equipment to try to get the debris off the road to try to open Highway 92 back up. This all started about 4 o'clock this morning when the sirens sounded. Normally, those sirens only sound in Oskaloosa for tornadoes, but officials were trying to alert residents that there was an impending situation and danger happening here in Oskaloosa. Victor, did you want to say one more thing?
Yeah, in the trailer house, there's a lady in there, she's bedfast, and her son and everything were standing on top of the beds, but the one lady was bedfast, and she can't even move it whatsoever.
So there you have it, Katie, and I think that it certainly has, as the sun's come up here, they are starting to get a little bit better picture about the damage and really what the extent of where this water came from and where it's going, but so far, it looks like it's receding below Highway 92 at this time. Back to you.
Okay, Joe, real quickly before you go, tell me, you said these residents say they haven't seen anything like this in 30 years. What exactly are you seeing?
Well, and I'll include Victor here, too. You haven't seen anything like this in 30 years. Tell the viewers on Channel 8 what it was you saw when the water was at its highest point.
The highest point, I got a low spot behind the building where there's a creek, and it usually the creek comes out a little bit, and maybe there's 3 foot of water back there at times, but they're a little better, but nothing like this in 30 years.
And Katie, it was just raging over the highway when we got here, just on the east edge of Oskaloosa, just next to the family restaurant here. So situation has improved, and again, potentially 10 lives saved here with quick efforts of the local officials.
And Joe, Highway 92, real quickly, just for our viewers this morning, is closed east and west of Oskaloosa right now?
We are east of Oskaloosa. Normally west of Oskaloosa floods first, so I wouldn't be surprised if that's not the case. But this rarely floods over the roadway, and there's a bike path that goes underneath here, and it may not have crossed this road in quite some time, but for sure it's closed here east of town.
Okay, thank you, Joe, for that great information. We'll check back in with you in about a half an hour.